Thousands of people will climb the CN Tower on Saturday and Sunday. Last year, climbers raised more than $1 million for the World Wildlife Fund. For many, though, the 1,776 steps to the top are also about meeting personal goals. People like Julian Backhouse. He has Wilson's disease, a rare condition that keeps him in a wheelchair much of the time. Mary Wiens met Julian climbing the stairs in his condo building, preparing for the CN Tower.
The stairwell of an 11-story condo building in Mississauga. This is where Julian trains, footsteps echoing against the brick walls. Julian calls it his ghost.
This is the ghost.
It was about 15 years ago when Julian first noticed something was wrong. Little things, opening jam jars was harder. Processing questions or responding, it all got tougher.
My thoughts go faster than my mouth, and I not this. It's like my paperwork is just disorganized.
Is that the disease, or is that the way you are?
No, that's the disease. So I used to have two piles of papers on my desk. Somebody asked me for a job, and they asked me what about the job. I tell them I would be able to find the job, but what happens now? I get totally lost. And I can't move paper around, so I move it one spot to the other, and then it gets disorganized. So those two flights don't have a reading on that side, so that gives me some difficulty.
Julian has Wilson's disease, a rare condition that begins at birth, but some of the symptoms don't show up until much later. In Julian's case, in his early 50s. Symptoms similar to Parkinson's, a shuffling gait, difficulty speaking. His life quickly unraveled.
I would I'd be upstairs when I had a house. I'd be upstairs and they'd find me at the bottom. I'd be falling. I'd trip. I'm lucky everything was carpeted. I'm tough. The walls at the bottom of the stairs were all had dents in it from my head.
Julian had to give up his business, selling drapes and bedspreads to the hotel industry. His marriage unraveled, and he had to use a wheelchair to get around. One day, he overheard one of his tenants talking about the CN Tower climb.
I says, well, I can do stair climbing. I don't have any trouble doing that.
Oddly enough, climbing stairs was easier than walking. The edge of every step provides a visual clue that seems to trigger physical movement.
In therapy, I had no trouble climbing the steps. It was only four steps. But I hold on to the rails, and that would steady me, because I was a little wobbly otherwise. If I walk flat, my feet drag sometimes, and I festate. That's when your feet feel glued to the ground.
It's called festate.
Festating. Well, it's a Parkinson term, your feet feeling glued. It feels like you can't lift it. So I would trip up.
Tell me a little bit about coming to watch your brother climb the stairs, the CN Tower stairs. Have you been here before for this climb?
Oh, yeah. This will be my third year. I
think Katie Clarer, Julian's sister, on the phone from California.
I started to join him on his second year.
Oh, so you actually climb with him?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. It is terribly exciting. Just from where he's come, he was having such difficulty, and there was a period in his life where they hadn't diagnosed him properly, and we thought we were going to lose him at that time. And
Katie is an occupational therapist. After Julian was diagnosed with Wilson's disease, she and her other siblings urged him to go into a supervised care home. Julian refused.
He has a lot of drive to push forward when anybody says that he can't. He just goes with what his gut believes he can do, and he just does it. Much to all of our surprise and admiration, he just does it. And he never speaks negatively about his situation either. At certain points, I would have definitely thought that he could have fallen into a deep, deep depression about it and be very angry, but he has never, ever been like that. There are people with far less injury who feel far more miserable.
Do you tell your own patients about your brother?
Oh yeah, all the time.
Wow.
Yeah, he's inspiring to a lot of people.
Thank you so
including myself.
No, two of you. I'm out of breath. 10 times this is for the CN Tower. I've done 5 times. So I get halfway. And that's why I don't want to practice.
After this weekend, Julian will take a break until the fall when he'll be back training in his stairwell. But even if the day comes when he can no longer do the climb, Julian says he'll still come back as a volunteer because he knows that for anyone finding their way back from a setback, a long, slow, patient climb may be the best way to get there. For CBC Radio, I'm Mary Wiens in Toronto.